So I have something very interesting to report. This morning I had this tremendous session, over 2 hour session, got into some tremendous heavy reorientation of valuing, and I said I'm gonna take it real easy so I tried to, but what happened was got into a problem with personality and tried to say, hey, you know, back off. Didn't work. So ended up getting very jangled, very upset and jangled. And what I'm finding out is the modern personality is totally incompatible with right spiritual practice. It's totally out of sync. Totally out of sync. So those who have decided to go along with the modern personality, they're completely out of sync with right spiritual practice. And there's no way in the world that you can integrate the two, of the modern personality and right spiritual practice. No. People have to back off the modern personality. It doesn't work. It's super disruptive, super dominant, super dismissive, super arrogant, cares not about, you know, it doesn't get the issue at all. Priorities upside down, everything incompatible. So there's this fundamental incompatibility, which is why those who are engaged in the spiritual and right spiritual practice have always tended to isolate themselves from society in general. And the hubris of the day is that somehow that's no longer necessary, and that somehow you should be able to integrate it all because we're all intelligent enough, we all have college degrees, we should be able to handle this no problem, integrate the modern personality with spiritual practice. What happens is the modern personality ends up dominating and dictating to those who want right spiritual practice how they have to live and what the terms need to be for them, that they're the ones who need to make the adjustment. It's not true. It's backing away from the personality that needs to take place. You can never integrate the two, personality and spirit. What you have to do is you have to back off personality to such an extent that it takes second place. Its priorities are second. They're not important. They're not valuable. There's no other way. When we put the personality and try to deify it, then you're automatically going to try to destroy right spiritual practice on this planet. It's automatic. You have no value for it. And you view it all as silly, you dismiss it as silly, stupidity. You know, these are dimwit people that need to be told what they should be valuing. That's the way the personality looks at it, that they're supposed to dictate to you what your values and valuing are supposed to be aligned with. And then it's up to you, you're supposed to respond to their leadership, as it were. So this is what I've been saying. I just experienced it, you know, firsthand for the millionth time, but it was particularly upsetting, being that I was on such a spiritual high, and then have that just, you know, interfered with for the most flimsy of reasons and pretexts, and it's just, you know, incredible, absolutely incredible. So again, I say there has to be some parting of the ways, some sorting out of this situation, and so far it hasn't happened. I'm just saying, when is it going to happen? It's already late in the game for that. It was like being thrown into icy water or something, you know, just like from this very warm, super good position, that place I was in, to be just thrown into this, you know, plunged into severely icy cold, bitter cold water. Of course, that's not welcome. So I'm at a loss for words to. You cannot integrate the two. Why we're still in this situation in the world is hard to fathom. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. People will back off the spiritual path. There's no question about it. they will refuse to go in depth like I just did, because the shock of meeting up with a personality is so unsettling. At that point, you want peace, calm, mood of repentance, understanding what is important, right priorities. You want that atmosphere present. Very much so. It's like you're giving birth to, like a newborn child, and you want things to be soft and quiet and calm. So it's a horrible experience. And usually I try to avoid everybody if possible, but it's not always possible. So what happens is you back off the path. No question about it, you back off the path. You back away from intense effort. Really, in the back of your mind, you're saying, wow, last time I did this, I had this very unpleasant experience, and so I don't want to do it again. Definitely. It's just a no-brainer. So I'm sure the Holy Spirit knows this. I just am shocked that I haven't had more movement on this. So I'm having to dig deeper into why, and I did get some glimpses into why we hold on to this very bad situation. Of course, it's fear of the continuity issue. That's exploited. There are those who exploit that. And they see it as a problem of they think, the personality thinks that the continuity problem is just a reluctance to commit to the personality. So personalities think that by associating with them, they will help you get over this problem you have to committing the personality. That's actually what it is. And so now I realize that, wow, that's not it at all. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a personality problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a commit to the personality problem. I have a continuity problem. That's the only problem that I have. So with this heightened awareness of what's going on, I'm able to see through this dynamic that we have, that we're really enslaved by the personality. And the personality is not the slightest bit willing to set us free at all. It doesn't even, from its standpoint, setting us free would be a disaster for us. We wouldn't have the benefit of associating with personalities. They see it as a great benefit to us. They see that we need to be re-educated, actually. Okay, let me make this very clear. The personality believes that those on the spiritual path need to be re-educated, that they're suffering from a lack of education, that they're suffering from wrong education. They don't realize that the personality is the answer. And so they need to be given the new opportunity to hang out and live with personality, live in the personality-driven world, and that will cure them of whatever uneasiness they have. That's how it's viewed. So the thing to do is to still stay calm and still look for the insight. Remember, it's a will question, it's a continuity problem question. It has to be that my will is still not properly aligned. It has to be. And I saw that there are some underlying issues that are keeping me trapped in here. Why did I come here in the first place? It's the reason why, for me, I came here in the first place is, in the situation I'm in, is I felt I had this very bad problem. I didn't know what it was. And so I thought that if the person get personalities to help me, who are dedicated to the personality, I thought maybe they could solve it. I didn't realize it was a continuity problem. So I sort of felt I needed some long-term pressure from the personality in order to get well. And that's what's happened. But then I saw it was a disaster. And I said, wow, this isn't working. And now that I know that my problem is actually the continuity problem, I don't feel like I need the personality anymore to help me out. I don't need personalities to help me out. So what before I thought it was all my fault, I needed to be blamed for all the personality problems and that I was supposed to, I was the one that had to change. Now I'm seeing, no. Once you've accepted the continuity problem, then you realize it's those who are addicted to the personality, they're the ones who have to change, not you. So I'm very unwilling to put up with personalities anymore. Very unwilling. I know how toxic it is, how it's total misdirection. And in trying to speak up the personalities again, I find I'm just completely dismissed as a silly little boy who hasn't learned the lessons yet, hasn't put their attention in the right place yet, hasn't been following the television, modern pop culture, hasn't gotten the right clues, the right education, the right molding, the right shaping, the right indoctrination, not following the right leadership, not going along with the entertainers and the pop stars and the, the personality stars, personality cult figures, not taking their lead, in other words, just misusing your time, not getting it. That's what's happening. That's their perspective, is you've just failed miserably to use your time in the right way. Otherwise, you'd be, glued to the television set, taking all your cues for interaction and ideas from the television actors. Much of it scripted, all of it tightly controlled, all of it very much on point and purpose of idolizing the personality. Totally egoic, 100% egoic, all of it. They think that's how you're supposed to spend your time. So their re-education would be to have you sit down and watch television 24 hours a day. For me, you could pay me all the money in the universe. You could say, you make me king of the universe, and all I would have to do is watch television. No deal. Rejected out of hand. There is no incentive that could be offered me to get me to watch television 24/7 like that. No incentive. Even 2 hours of it. No incentive whatsoever. No such incentive exists. But that's their idea of re-education, thinking that they got to, there's some of us who are lagging behind, and we need to strengthen our personality, our addiction to the personality, which is just a whole jumble, conglomerate of delaying devices, is all it is. And they think that that's salvation, because you're avoiding the continuity problem. Somehow that cures your fear or something. No, it doesn't. It just postpones it. It just kicks it down the road. It just delays it. Fear is still there. In fact, it gets worse. It gets worse. The more you delay, the worse it gets. And when you try to explain it to the personality, your position, they don't say, I got no time for this. It's just waste. You're wasting my time. In other words, a stone wall. You can't have a conversation saying, hey, I got a different viewpoint. Can I explain why my viewpoint's different? No. You're off script. You're off script. They say, stick to the script. We have a script to follow. You're off script. You're like, oh, it's like actors in a play. If someone starts saying something that is not on the script, all the actors will look and say, what are you talking about? You're not on script. You get off. You're banned from this production. You can't stay on script. It's like that. So you cannot defend yourself. You cannot explain yourself. You cannot say, hey, this is what I'm doing. They have no desire to entertain, to spend their time that way. They feel it's time totally wasted for them because they feel they're right anyway. So why should they listen to you? They're just doing you a favor, but they're not interested in what you have to say because they say they know they're right. They say the personality is where it's at. This is what's right, and we're sure of it. Or at least our idols told us that we're sure of it. So this is just a again, driven home the enormous problem we have on this planet. And for me, it's a deal breaker, total deal breaker. There is no deal, actually. You can't make a deal with the ego. And we need to realize that. The fact that we can't make a deal with the ego is the deal breaker. So the deal has been broken because it's not possible to make a deal. You know, most people are scripted. They're scripted, they're programmed, they're scripted into what they can look at, what they can listen to, what they can say. It's all scripted for them. And they say anybody goes off script is ruining the whole production. It's a production, this whole thing. A con job on trying to con God. So, rather than blaming the Holy Spirit, we got no choice but to look within and see what our expectations are valuing. And I've just found I'm not remotely on the same page as the personality. Night and day difference. I can see what the personality is up to. I can see the delay tax that they're using. The personality refuses to acknowledge or admit any of this. It's just there is no real communication at all. So why should we be forced to stay in such a situation? It makes no sense at all to me. It doesn't add up in the slightest bit. To help them out, right now they're beyond help. Scripted. And they wouldn't value our help anyway. They're going to go to the help that they value. And so you've got a long turnaround as far as what they're, you know, what's being valued as far as help goes. We're like completely off the radar as far as what's valued. They'll go to, when they feel they need help, they'll go to what they've been scripted of where to go for help. So for me, I'm feeling very much unacknowledged as far as movement on this all-important issue. You can't possibly overlook it. It's the most blatant issue there is right now. You can't mix the two. You can't mix the super uber dominant personality cult with right spiritual practice. It's oil and water. And they say, well, if you got something, it's up to you. If you're so spiritual, it's up to you to blend it in then with what we're doing. That's what they say, that you should have the ability to blend it, because the ego tells them that blending truth and lies is the highest accomplishment. So they automatically assume that if you got something to teach me, you got to use the words, you got to be on script with what I expect, otherwise how can you help me? So you just are stonewalled at every possible step, and ultimately they just say, well, you just, you know, be a slave service, and that's actually really good for you, because they're looking at what is good for you. They think they know what's good for you, and that is to hang around the personality. They say, well, you don't have anything to say to me, anything to teach me. I have nothing to learn from you, but I will help you by letting you hang around me, and I'll have you just do all these menial jobs, menial tasks. And, you know, you basically were Cinderella. That's the story of Cinderella. It is the stepmother and the stepdaughters were this personality, dominant personality, and Cinderella was the one on the spiritual path. And they forced Cinderella into servitude, just thinking that they were doing her a huge favor by even letting her hang around. But then she did all the menial tasks, and etc., and they worked on all the primping their personality up. And then along came the prince, and who did the prince choose? Cinderella. Along came the spiritual focus. You've been admitting you have a continuity problem. You've been working on your continuity problem. Here's the vision of oneness for you. And the others are just like totally flabbergasted and shocked and say, this is completely insane. Cinderella's nothing. She has nothing to offer. She's a complete idiot. She's retarded, actually. They thought she's mentally retarded. Personality thinks those on the spiritual path are mentally retarded, actually. And the real mental retardation, which is those who the personality call, is glorified. It's backwards, upside down and backwards. So we're just saying, where is the Prince Charming? Where is the help for those who are the Cinderellas, who are, you know, being really exploited by the personality? It's the new exploited class, actually. It's the new untouchable class. It's the new class that is being discriminated against. If there are many even left in that class, because most have realized, wow, gotta bail out of this. This is just too tough. So, starting to stay on point here. Did something significant. I bought a bunch of vegetables to plant this year, but I made a decision. I said, you know what? I'm not going to plant them. One, that's a commitment. I don't like gardening, actually. I hate it. I just do it to keep up appearances. You know, like that I'm working hard, doing something positive that the personality likes, right? I really don't like it at all. Two, we have this horrific drought in California. I can't justify watering a vegetable garden all summer. That's just not correct. So I bought all these plants. I'm going to try to return them now. I'm going to try to return them. Never done that in my life, but I'm going to try to return them. I don't want that responsibility. What the personality does is it piles on all these stupid responsibilities to keep you busy. It cuts into your spiritual effort time. It cuts into it severely. And I think they're doing you a favor. They see that you're spending your time, as we are, as totally wasted time. So they're saying, hey, stay busy with this. Hey, I got something to stay busy with. Hey, take care of this. I got this. They think they're doing you a favor. So I will try to return the plants. God willing, I'll be able to. I'll cut off the water to the garden, and that's it. Not going to water this garden anymore. So, I am pretty much incredulous that there has not been more clarity on what to do about this personality issue. But raising it to light like this should be very helpful. And at least we have this focus that's something we really have to get some clarity on this as fast as possible, because it has crystallized as I predicted. I said in March you would see this crystallization, you would see a severe problem, this ideological World War III take place, and it is taking place. I am feeling it. I am feeling the pressure. What is war? One group trying to exert their dominance over another. That's what war is, right? It doesn't have to be, you know, sometimes it's fists, sometimes it's spears, bow and arrow, and knives, and eventually, you know, and elephants and horses, lances, and all these various different things. It's one group trying to enforce their dominance on another. That is what war is. We have a world war right now where we have the personality, one group trying to enforce their dominance on the whole planet. So it's a world war. It's a war. A war is one group trying to force their dominance, assert their dominance, and force servitude on another group. That is war. And the methods now are different than used in the past. You know, it's economic, it's legal system, it's social pressure, it's all these various bureaucratic laws and fears that people have of being put in trouble. And it's a whole conglomeration of methods and technologies that they have to assert dominance of the personality over those who are oriented towards the continuity problem, the vision of oneness and the Holy Spirit, and right spiritual practice, and living a lifestyle, orienting our values in that direction. It is an attempt to assert their dominance over this group. It is a war. It is a world war. Take it seriously. It's not a joke. Okay, if you use the definition of war, you think about it. It's one group of people say, hey, you know what, those people over there, we deserve to dominate them. They don't deserve all the riches they have, the land they have, the freedom they have. We feel that they should work for us. We should own that land. We should get the riches from it. We're superior to them. Let's go and take it from them. Let's assert our dominance over them. So we can tax them, so we can enslave them. You know, that's warfare. So, we are in World War III. It started in early March of 2014. And I've noticed this just come full out now. Crystallized attitude. It's a crystallized attitude now of, we're going to tell you what you're going to do, and you're going to do it whether you like it or not. That's dominance, asserting their dominance over the situation. Irrespective of a fact, which is the fact is we all have a continuity problem, and that's our only problem. They're just denying that and saying, no, that's not it. So we're in World War III, and hopefully we get posted. We get a commission and get posted somewhere. Super important. I'm all for it. I'm all ready for it. Okay, very great. That's it for this one.